From artificial intelligence to a boot camp, these are the highlights from the second day of ESA's Fee Week in Italy. Artificial intelligence for Earth observation, or AI for EO, was the main topic of the day. Now, this isn't exactly about walking, talking robots, but scientists are training artificial intelligence how to correctly analyze images of our planet coming from space-borne satellites. This technology is providing us with vital information on our environment and adding value for the end user.
Yeah, I want to concentrate and it's talk.
For experts like Patrick Helber, the next best things to come for AI for EO will be the result of the vast amounts of data being made available through Europe's Copernicus program.
For artificial intelligence and currently the methods which are state of the art, we need a large amount of data, and this is exactly what we are given by the Copernicus program. Now we have to create a ground truth data set so that we can really train our AIs and getting a global AI running automatically on these images.
Also on Tuesday, a session dedicated to the status of and opportunities for launchers was held. Focus was on Europe's Vega small launcher and the future Ariane 6 rocket, two programs that are working to secure Europe's independent access to space. For 3 days, budding entrepreneurs and young professionals have been working to create their own startups related to space, food, and energy. 35 participants from 16 different countries collaborated on new ideas and business models that offer solutions to real-world problems with Earth observation data in the first ever Fee Week bootcamp.
In undeveloped countries, there's a lot of waste which causes disease and they don't have energy. So if we can connect these two things, and then with the information provided through satellites, where we can identify the key areas that have the right conditions for these microbes that causes this, that in relation to where the electricity is needed, we can overlay all this information with this device to then help those people there.
It's about trying to gather information from satellite imagery plus information that's produced by farmers and information, existing information about weather and soil conditions to try to help farmers manage their crops in a better way, so they are part of this chain where they are also producing information that is saving other farmers to track how they are doing on their agricultural production.
We want to use big data and methods of Industry 4.0 to find the perfect location for companies and industry that plans new subdivisions. For example, if there's a company, Amazon is a good example, that planned a new headquarter, we could step in and use new methods, for example, Earth observation data also, to plan the perfect new headquarter.
The Earth observation data sets are absolutely massive, and a lot of people actually use a fraction of that the Earth observation data that's delivered to them. So we're really trying to crunch it down to much more sizable pieces that match the semantic need of that user. So if someone is interested in urban settlements, he will only get the cropped out Earth observation data that he needs over those urban settlements.
So we're developing a web-based dashboard to improve water usage in agriculture for food production.
These farmers are buying a very low, cheap price rice from the Southeast Asia, and that is completely unsustainable, and we want to make a better health for the European people, to make it more sustainable rice and to produce inside Europe, and we want to use the open satellite data to giving them all kind of service what they basically need. From this way we want to help them to produce more and to get a beneficiary for everyone over here.
The replays of selected events and exclusive interviews happening here at Fee Week are available on our website, so check out www.esa.int. I'm Kelsey Brennan-Wessels for ESA Web TV. Thanks for watching.